In this one, we're gonna see the different ways to split a string in C, because well, it doesn't have like a string type. It just has character pointers terminated by the null character, as you probably know. And so you have to rely on a few tricks to split a string, which I'm gonna show you in this video. So the first approach is just try to copy what like most regular languages do, which is you create a function which is not a part of the standard library, and this function will allocate, don't worry too much about what I'm copy pasting, and this function will allocate to the array of strings. So above is like a function that we did in school, but you don't have to worry too much about what it does, just that it's called a split. It returns an array of strings. It takes one string and it takes a character, which is going to be the delimiter for each part that we want to have split out. And as you can see, it does a malloc for the whole array, and it does a str and dup, which will allocate as well a string for each part of them. So that's how I think most mainstream language do it. And as you can see, that's how you would use it. So I will put that split function in a gist if you want, and link it in the description if you want to copy paste and use it in your project. And so at the end, you get an array of string, as I said, and that's how you use it. You give it a string, give it a delimiter, and at the end you have an array. I should precise that you know that it's the end of the array, because there is a it's a null terminated array. So when you hit null, you know it's the end of it. And so if you compile that, as you can see, okay, I put two twos in my example string, but as you can see, it gives you yeah, what you would expect. But of course, the downside of this is it's allocated, so you have to free each string in it, and you also have to free the whole array, which is a bit cumbersome. And so the more C-like way of doing this is to use two functions which are in the standard library, and the first one is strtoc. Like so. And so here you can see I have still a string, which is just the same list of numbers that I had before. And then the way the strtoc function works is a bit strange. So you first call it like so. You create so token is going to store the parts of the string. And the strtoc, the first time you call it, you give it the string you want to split and the delimiter. And then it will return you the first token. And then you do a while loop, while token is different than null, because when strtoc doesn't find any more part to split, it will return null. I mean, here I print the token to show what it is. And then you recall strtoc, which will, and again, token is equal to strtoc. And you re-give the same delimiter, but you give it null. So the strtoc stored the string s somewhere, and will, every time you call it with a null argument, it will go to the next element. And yeah, and that doesn't require any allocation, because what it's doing under the hood, at least I assume, it's so the first time you call it, it literally replaces the comma character by a null character, and then the second time you call it with null, it's gonna do the same thing here, replace it with null, and so on and so on and so on. And so it just, you have to give it a string that is modifiable, so either an array of characters or a mallocked string, and that's how it works. So zero allocation, but the downside is, of course, it will modify your current string. So this won't apply in every single case, but there is a lot of cases where you actually don't really need to have like each part mallocked individually, and you just need to iterate over each part. And this way, it's yeah, much more, I think, efficient and clean as well. But the STR talk has a downside is that it doesn't handle empty fields. So if you have a bunch of delimiters like so, it will not do empty. It just won't do like empty part of the splitted thing. And also I think that calling it with null afterward is very strange. So yeah, I wouldn't use it, but there is an alternative, but this alternative is not completely standard from what I understood, is strsep. So like so, let me copy my example. And this one is a bit saner. So same example, it's that you have to have a pointer, not a string pointer, not an array. But as you can see, I still have my string, I have the token, and then I have a while loop where this time strsep in its first argument takes a pointer to the string. No, yeah, so you have the string which is a character pointer, but it will modify this pointer, so you need to give it the address of this pointer, if that makes sense to you. And then again, the delimiter. And we always assign it to token, until and when it's null, it means that there is no more tokens. And as you can see, it's the same behavior where it gives you a number. But the upside of strsep is that it can handle empty fields. So you give it empty fields like this. You see that it gave you empty strings. And also, yeah, I think this is cleaner, giving the address to the string instead of null after the first initialization, which I find a bit strange. So if you have the choice between the two, I would use strsep personally. But yeah, and under the hood, of course, it does the same thing where it replaces the delimiter by null characters. So so yeah, that's it. That's how you would efficiently split a string in C. I mean, iterate over the splitted part of a string, not really like split it. Which is really efficient when you have to parse some text or something. Yeah, that's it. Hope this makes your program faster and your life easier. And see you in the next one.